हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम बैक। लेक्चर टू, मॉड्यूल वन, माइक्रो कंट्रोलर एंड एम्बेडेड सिस्टम। संगीता रॉय, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट। कंटेंट, लेक्चर वन, मॉड्यूल वन, माइक्रो कंट्रोलर 8051 आर्किटेक्चर, डिफरेंस बिटवीन So in the lecture 1, module 1, we have already discussed about microcontroller 8051 architecture, difference between microcontroller and microprocessor. So today's content is commercial microcontroller devices and families. Microcontroller 80C31 or 80C32 or 80C51 8-bit microcontroller family. So these three are in the same family, that is 8-bit microcontroller. 126 or 256 byte RAM, ROM, low voltage 2.7 volt to 5.5 volt, low power, high speed 33 megahertz speed it can process. It is general specification. Now description. Philips 80C31, 32 is a high performance static 80C51 design fabricated with Philips high density CMOS technology. It is a kind of microcontroller, but there are numerous other also. CMOS technology with operation from 2.7 volt to 5.5 volt. Intel also one of the premier name in this field. 8031, 32 ROM less devices contain 128/8 RAM, 256 into 8 RAM, 32 IO lines, 3 16-bit counter or timers, a 6 source, 4 priority level, nested interrupt structure, a serial IO port for either multiprocessor communications, IO expansion or full duplex UART or on-chip oscillator and clock circuits. In addition, the device is a low-power static design which offers a wide range of operating frequency down to zero. Two software selectable modes of power reduction, idle mode and power down mode, are available. The idle mode freezes the CPU while allowing the RAM, timer, serial port and interrupt system to continue functioning. The power down mode saves the RAM contents but freezes the oscillator, causing all other chip function to be inoperative. Since the design is static, the clock can be stopped without loss of user data and then execution resumed from the point the clock was stopped. Selection table. For application required more ROM, RAM, see the C8C5458, 8XC51RA, RBRC and RA plus datasheet. Thus, datasheet specified how it can be worked and acquired is the application area. So, according to the ROM size, RAM size, programmable timer counter and hardware watchdog timer. So, 0 to 4K, it is 128-bit RAM size with 8-bit line, data line. Programmable timer counter, not required. Hard watchdog timer, not required. Then it is 0, 8, 16 or 32 ROM or EEPROM. RAM size is 256 and two columns, don't require. Then in the case of 51 RA, 51 RA RB and RC, 0, 8, 16, 32K ROM or EEPROM, then RAM size is 512. Then 8XC51RD+64K 10824 RAM size and programmable timer counter, yes it is, and also watchdog timer is also there. Features: 8051 central processing unit, 128 into 8 RAM, 256 into 8 RAM for 32 and 128 into 8 RAM for 31. 3 16-bit counter or timers, Boolean processor, full static operation, low voltage 2.7 volt to 5.5 volt at a rate of 16 megahertz clock operation. Memory addressing capability 64K ROM and 64K RAM. Power control modes. Clock can be stopped and resumed, idle mode, power down mode, and CMOS and TTL compatible. Two speed ranges are VCC is equal to 5 volt in the range of 0 to 16 megahertz and the range of 0 to 33 megahertz. Three package style extended temperature ranges, dual data pointers, four level priority interrupt, six interrupt sources, four 8-bit IO ports, full duplex enhanced UART, framing error detection and automatic address recognition. Programmable clock out, asynchronous port reset, low EMI, inhibit ALE, arithmetic logic address latch enabling. Wake up from power down by external interrupt. 8051 and 8651 and 8031 ordering information. For ROMless, temperature range 0 to plus 70 degrees Celsius, plastic dual in package, voltage range is 2.7 to 5.5 volt, frequency of operating is 0 to 16 megahertz, drawing number is slot 129. It is, means how it is in the operation it is given. Slot means in the where it is placed, it is also, there is a structure, in that structure there are slots, in that slot 129 to 1. And ROMless of the second criteria in the row, it is 0 to 70 degrees Celsius plastic leaded chip carrier and voltage is 2.7 volt to 5.5 volt, frequency of operation is 0 to 16 volt, slot 187 2. Then the next one is 0 to 17 degrees Celsius plastic quad flat pack, 2.7 volt to 5.5 volt, 0 to 16 frequency megahertz range, slot 3072. Then it is minus 40 to plus 85 plastic dual in package, 2.7 volt to 5.5 volt, 0 to 16 megahertz operating range and 129.1 is the slot. Then the next is for minus 40 to plus 85 degrees Celsius, plastic leaded chip carrier 2.7 volt to 5.5 volt, 0 to 16 volt, 0 to 16 megahertz operation and 187/2 in the slot range. Minus 40 to plus 85 degrees Celsius plastic quad flat pack 2.7 volt to 5.5 volt, 0 to 16 frequency megahertz operation and slot is 307/2. Part number derivation. Device number, operating frequency range, maximum in second, temperature range, and then package. First one is P8031, S is equal to 16 MHz maximum, temperature is 0 to 70 degrees Celsius, package is PLCC, it is also specification based. P8032, maximum frequency is 33 megahertz minus 40 to 85 operating temperature range. It is BB. If it is configuration BB, then it is PQFC. If it is PN, PDIP. Dual in package. Then 8032 ordering information. ROMless, it is first, earlier it was, it is for 51, 8051 or 8751, but for this one it is 8032 ordering information. ROMless, the first row indicates in the range of 0 to 70 dual in package, then frequency range is 16 megahertz. Earlier the indication is dual in package, this one is PDIP. See earlier one. So it is PDIP, PLCC, this is all code this one. So frequency of operating frequency is 16 megahertz. Drawing number is 129.1, and the next row indicates 0 to plus 70 dual leader chip carrier, frequency 16 and slot 187.7. Next one is 0 to 70 plastic quad flat pack and frequency range is 16, slot is 307/2. Then it is minus 40 to 85 plastic dual in package, it is also 16, and next one is 129.1 and so on, and last one is minus 42 plus 85 plastic quad flat pack and frequency range is 33 megahertz and slot is 307/2. Now this is the block diagram, general idea of block diagram, and for 8051 controller we will study in detail. So it is a general block diagram of any type of microcontroller. There may be little bit of change, but overall it is the diagram. There is some crystal oscillator is there, there is timing and control circuit, there is timers, RAM, ROM, static pointer, accumulator, program counter, buffer, and everything it is given over there, supply voltage connector, then serial port in, serial port out, everything is showing over there. Arithmetic logic unit, accumulator, everything is temporary register 1, temporary register 2, and then it is register are there, adder register are there, port are there, everything is there, we will discuss later in detail. So this is the logic symbol, it is clearly shown, the crystal oscillator is showing over there, address and data bus are showing over there. This is plastic leaded chip carrier pin function, 1 to 44 pins are showing over there. This is leaded chip carrier pin function, LCC, logic leaded chip carrier. Then it is pin configuration, dual in line package, plastic quad flat pack pin functions, 1 to 44, but it is plastic quad flat pack pin functions. So these are the pin description are there. In the next slides, it is clearly shown. So this is the picture total, but it is splitted over there. So it is mnemonic and corresponding the pin numbers. And what is the function? Say first one, say VSS, mnemonic. It is, if it is the DIP structure, then the pin number 20. If it is LCC, then the pin is 22. If it is QFP, then it is 16. Type is 1. Name and function grounded, 0 volt reference, power supply, this is the power supply, voltage for normal, idle and power down operation. Port 0 is an open drain bidirectional IO port with schematic trigger input. Port 0 pins that have a once written to them float and can be used as high impedance inputs. Port 0 is also the multiplex low order address and data bus during access to external program and data memory. In this application, it is uses strong internal pull-up when emitted once. So this is the how it is operating according to the pin it is showing. It is also the continuation of that. Then the table 1, C51, 8031, special function register. This is the special function register. This is also splitted. Lot of registers are over there, and how the values are setted, it is, and their corresponding address, how they can be accessed, which is shown over there. This is the remaining part. Oscillator characteristics. Earlier I have shown you the oscillator circuit. I'm showing you again. These are the oscillator XTAL1 and XTAL2. So these oscillators are showing over there. Yes. XTAL1 and XTAL2 are the input and output respectively of an inverting amplifier. The pins can be configured for the use as on an on-chip oscillator as shown in the logic symbol. To drive the device from an external clock source, XTALY should be driven while XTAL2 is left unconnected. There are no requirements on the duty cycle of the external clock signal because the input to the internal clock circuitry is through divide by two flip-flop. However, minimum and maximum high and low time specified in the data sheet must be observed. Reset. A reset is accomplished by holding the RST pin high for at least two machine cycles, 24 oscillator periods. While the oscillator is running, to ensure a good power up reset, the RST pin must be high long enough to allow the oscillator to time to start up plus two machine cycles. Stop clock mode. The static design enables the clock speed to be reduced down to 0 MHz. When the oscillator is stopped, the RAM and special function register retain their values. This mode allows step-by-step utilization and permits reduced system power consumption by lowering the clock frequency down to any value. For lowest power consumption, the power down mode is suggested. Idle mode. In idle mode, it will be shown in table 2. The CPU puts itself to sleep while all of on-chip peripherals stay active. The instruction to invoke the idle mode is last instruction executed in the normal operating mode before the idle mode is activated. The CPU contains the on-chip RAM and all of the special function register remain intact during this mode. The idle mode can be terminated either by any enabled interrupt or by a hardware reset which starts the processor in the same manner as a power on reset. This is table 2. External pin status during idle and power mode or power down modes. For idle mode, programmable memory is internal ALE, address latch enable ALE is 1, PSEN, it is equal to, this is the programmable status. It will be shown later in the main topic. 1 and data port 0 is equal to data port 1, data port 2, data port 3, also data. Idle mode, if it is external, then ALE 1, PSEN 1, data port 0 float, data port 1 data port 2 address, data port 3 is data. Then power down mode internal, then it is 00, then data. Power down mode external 00 float data. Therefore, it indicates how the circuit will operate it according to this pin configuration. So this is how the microcontroller looks. It is shown over there. So working with microcontroller can be divided into three steps. Programming the microcontroller, burning it inside the IC, connect to the external network. Microcontroller programming is very much similar to the programming language like C. So this is a line follower robot. How microcontroller can be used in a particular application, it is shown in this figure. So this is another application of microcontroller or embedded system in the robotics. It is used widely. Microcontroller in medical devices also used. Microcontrollers in power systems. So we can use microcontroller in numerous ways. Everything modern technology is totally based on this microcontroller and embedded technology system. So student, you have to learn the subject thoroughly and its application is wide. We can say there is no other alternative of this microcontrollers and mostly embedded system. It is tending to numerous way in IoT microcontroller sensor, they are the predominated player in this field. So if we can learn this thoroughly, in future is very bright, so you have to go through this. So for today's session, we are ending over there. These are the references. And in the earlier class, we have also given you idea of von Neumarck, Harvard architecture. how it is difference and the software. So we are ending the session. Thank you.